March 25th at patch one, and you can see each of these spots that is discolored. I just took a sample of soil. It's about time to get the soil tests in. This patch is nice and dry and fluffy and really easy to work with. Patch two is still really wet and holding a lot of water, but each of those holes that I dug, I put a couple handfuls of soil into this bucket, and then I'll mix this up and then take the recommended amount. I send my soil test to Western Laboratories, and really for this patch, I'm trying to see what kind of amendments I need to do. Last year, I adjusted the pH in this patch to bring it down because it's slightly basic. So I added some elemental sulfur. So I want to see if that effect has taken hold. I also have a little hoop house set up just to see if I can impact the temperature of the soil. The soil temperature is showing about 80 degrees in here. I don't know if you can see that, about 80 degrees. So that's really good. That's what you want to see. And this hoop house has been up for a couple weeks, so it's just kind of constantly getting solar energy. And then just as a point of comparison, I'll come out here into sort of the middle of the patch and do a test and see where we're at. So I'll come back in just a second. It is sitting at about 65 degrees. So basically having the small hoop houses, especially if you leave them up for as long as you can before you actually go and plant your transplants, is a good way to get the soil temperature raised. Seeing 80 degrees inside the hoop house is right what we're hoping for. In patch two, like I mentioned, it's still really pretty wet. You can see. So what I did is I took some samples like I did at patch one, and I turned them over. They were real wet, and just kind of took them out as they were. And then I broke them up, took the top layer off, and then I laid them out over a big pan over here, and basically just let them dry out. I cleaned this thing thoroughly beforehand, laid all the soil out just to get the sogginess out of it. And then I brought it into the bucket once it was dried out, and it looks more like a normal sample. And then, picked out chunks of wood and clumps and things like that. And then transfer them over to a bag here. It's probably still a little bit too much in here. So that's patch two, and this is patch one, ready to go out. And we'll see what we got and what we need to adjust. All right, my soil test results have come back for both patches. The patch number one is what's on screen right now. The test result is actually here on the left. Anything in green are the results that I got for my particular patch. And if you're a new grower, whether you're growing vegetables in your garden or you're trying to grow pumpkins, big pumpkins, getting a test result is really helpful. It gives you an idea where you're at, both with your pH and with your different micro and macronutrients. And Western Labs does a really good job of spitting out a recommendation of how many ounces of a given nutrient that you're either deficient or imbalanced in that you need to add per 1,000 square feet. So it's a really quick and easy way to improve your soil. However, if you want to go to the next step, a calculator over here on the right is something that was created by a fellow giant pumpkin grower, Bryan Langley. It's a little bit more advanced. You enter the square footage of your patch. You take all of the nutrient results from the test here on the left, and you input them in here in blue. It'll take that number and generate what your values are by percentage relative to what is recommended for giant pumpkin growing. It also compares your micro and macronutrient relationships. For example, this is calcium and magnesium, and what your actual ratio between those micro and macronutrients are versus an ideal ratio that has been sort of generated by other pumpkin growers in a study some number of years ago. It also generates your pH. So if you need to adjust your pH, if you're trying to move it up or down, it helps you calculating how much sulfur or lime you need to add. I'm not going to go into all the details of how to use this calculator because there's a really good video on YouTube, which I will link, that was put out by Cecil Weston, who's a fantastic grower. His video does a really good job of explaining how to use the calculator. So I'll put a link there. The gist of it is, based on your square footage, based on your test results, you can make adjustments to your, these are amendments that you can add. So you input different amounts of amendments. So this is a big drop down with lots and lots of things to select from. You can enter your own if needed. You move these around to ultimately get your NPPM and percentage values in the range that you want, as well as the ratios between your macro and micronutrients, because there's a relationship between the cation and anion. It has a lot to do with how the plant can actually utilize nutrient in the soil. So that's a very shortened version. I encourage you to watch the Cecil Weston video if you're interested in looking a little bit further. But for patch number one, boron, manganese, copper, kelp meal, alfalfa meal, and blood meal are the main nutrients that I'm going to add to get my soil into a pretty close to balanced state, and that'll be where I go. So I'll quickly show you what the second patch looks like, and then we'll move on to actually doing the amending. All right, here on the left is the results from patch number two. Keep in mind, this is a brand new patch, new ground, never been grown on. The only thing that I've done that now shows up in this test is in the fall, I planted a cover crop. I spread about 7 yards of compost. I adjusted the pH up, which the results show the pH is now showing up as 7.2, where it was slightly acidic before. So the results are very different from patch number one. The ground and soil type is quite a bit different. I'm not gonna go through all the individual details, but you can see the results in terms of what I'm applying. There's some balanced fertilizer, some sulfate of potash, some boron, manganese, and again, kelp, blood meal, and alfalfa meal. And that's gotten the ratios and the overall percentages a lot closer to an ideal state. So that's where we're headed. Here's some of the amendments from the soil test results that I'm going to be applying to the two different patches. This is not everything. There's a lot of micronutrients, which are in really small quantities. But you can see here, we got a bunch of alfalfa meal, blood meal, kelp meal, sulfate of potash, and a general 15-15-15 fertilizer.
Well, all week we've had high 70s and even a couple of days in the 80s. Which would have been a perfect time to till and amend the patch, but unfortunately I was away on a work trip, flew in late last night, and it rained about a half inch last night, and it's raining right now. So not ideal, but we're gonna try and get the amendment spread and get the patch tilled here in patch one, and we'll see about patch two. It's more sensitive to water over there, so might have to wait another couple days. But the goal, at least today, is to get the amendments in, get the patch tilled. This was just sort of a temporary location for the hoop house, but get the hoop houses in their two spots where the plants will go, and that'll give about a week to just sort of heat up the soil. The patch has been tilled, and now I'm going to spread all the amendments. There's some micronutrients, so some boron, manganese, what else do I have? Some blood meal, kelp meal, and alfalfa meal for the small micronutrients. I also have copper, which I don't have out here yet, but so the copper, boron, and manganese are all in such small quantities. I use that play sand in a bucket, mix it up so it's something bigger to spread, because when you're trying to spread like half of a pound of something out into here, 1500 square feet, is just too difficult. So I'll mix up my micronutrients in a sort of special blend, and I'll walk around and spread that, and then I'll do the bigger ones. So alfalfa meal is like 50 pounds, 25 pounds of kelp meal, and 10 or so pounds of blood meal will go out. So really not a ton of stuff that's going into the patch. It has now been amended and the final till is completed, and everything that the soil test showed me has been adjusted, at least theoretically, and now
final step is I'm going to set up the hoop houses in the two locations that the pumpkins are going to grow in. So for the little hoop houses, what I do is I drive these little pieces of rebar into the ground, and then I have a half inch PVC that creates the hoop shape. And then I use, you see the plastic over there on the ground, I use the plastic to cover, and binder clips, which was a great idea from another grower that I saw on a video. And those binder clips just clip perfectly over the half inch PVC. So I'll show you here. There's the PVC slid over the rebar. And I think it's about 9 feet long, maybe 7 feet wide. And that's what one of the hoop houses looks like. You can see I got some bricks on one end to hold it down, and the clips holding the plastic onto the half inch PVC. How this works is it just snaps on. Very clever idea. I didn't come up with it, but it's a good idea. Works well. All right, here we are at patch two. Patch two is still just a little bit too wet to till and do the amending. So I gotta wait a day, maybe 2 days, but we still have a week before I'm planting. So really the plan will be is just let it dry out a bit and then till, amend. I'm also adding some perlite and quite a bit more material or nutrients on this patch, just given that it's its first year based on the soil test, there's more that's required. So I'll do those things in a day or two, probably make it a separate video. And then we'll be planting in a week.